we are now going to measure the different parameters of directional coupler. So this is the directional coupler. It is a 4-port network. So if this one is port 1, this one will be port 2, this one is port 3, and this one, this is actually a port. This is blocked, but it is a port. So this one is port 4. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. It is a so if you put some, if you insert some power here, then some power will appear here and a portion of power will appear right here. Okay. So we are now going to measure different parameters for this particular network. Now to measure different parameters, you need to measure the power at different ports. So you have to measure the power at port 1, port 2, port 3 and port 4. Now if port 1 is the input port, then 2, 3 and 4 should be the output port. But how we can measure the power at port 1? See, this is the experimental setup. We are using Klystron mount, isolator, frequency meter, attenuator and the detector with mount, and also we are using this multimeter as microammeter. Okay, so this is the setup, experimental setup. So we have to connect this right here. Okay, now the power coming from the source will be coupled to port 1, right? So if we measure the power at this point, that will be the power at port 1, right? So you have to take the reading of the input power. So this one will be P1. So this one is the P1. Right now, this is the power at port 1. So P1 means port 1 power is this one, 24 point. Okay. Then you have to remove this detector and you have to connect this coupler. Okay. So you made the connection. So now it is connected. And you have to use at least 2 screw and nuts right here and here, diagonally opposite direction, so that it couples properly. Okay. It is better to use 4 screw and nuts, but considering the time, you can connect with the help of 2 screw and nuts, but they must be diagonally opposite direction. Okay, you have to use one stand, otherwise it will be unstable. Now this one is the port 2, this one is port 1, 2, 3 and this one is 4, right? So we have already measured the power at port 1. Now the detector is connected to port 2, right? And detect for measurement, proper measurement, again you have to connect screws properly in diagonal direction. But you have to measure this power subject to the condition all the other ports are match terminated, right? This one is already built in match terminated. So inside this waveguide we have some match termination, and you have to connect this match termination, this one is the match termination, properly. And for the alignment we have to use these screws. Okay, so to measure the power at port 2, you have to make sure that port 3 and port 4 are match terminated, right? Under this condition you have to measure, press it properly, so you can measure the power like this one. 2.8 volt, right? Now if we want to measure the power at port 3, what we have to do? We have to disconnect this connector, we have to disconnect this detector, and we have to connect here, and we have to disconnect this mass termination, and we have to reconnect it right here. Then we can measure the power at port 3. So let us do it. Now the detector is connected at port 3, detector mount is connected at port 3, and this mass termination is connected at port 2. So now we can measure the power at port 3, and this is the power at port 3. Okay. So port 2 is already measured, port 3 is measured. Now we have to measure the power at port 4, which is the isolated port. Now unfortunately this port is blocked, right? So what we have to do? We cannot open it, right? So let us now see how we can measure the power at port 4, though this power will be zero, but I am showing you how to measure it. Okay, to measure the power at port 4, we have connected this coupler in a reverse direction, since this one is bilaterally symmetric. So now this port becomes port 1, this one becomes port 2, this one becomes port 3, and this one becomes port 4, right? So we have connected, since we are going to measure, we want to measure the power at port 4, we have to connect this detector mount at port 4. This one is now port 4. Okay, so these two ports must be mass terminated. This one is already mass terminated internally, and we have to connect the mass termination at port 2 right here. So this is the connection. Okay, so under this condition you have to measure the power. Power is obviously zero, because this equipment is not sensitive enough to measure such low power, because since this port is isolated, so it is expected that extremely low power will appear here, and our measurement system is not so sensitive. Okay, so it is showing zero. So power at port 4 is zero. And remember that you have to connect in the opposite direction, just in the reverse direction. Okay, so this is how we can measure the power at port 4. And don't forget to note the beam voltage and repeller voltage. Right. So this is the experimental setup for measurement of different parameters of a coupler. Right now we are using this model XK310. Okay, XK310. We have another coupler, XK303. So we have to measure it for both the couplers. Okay, the procedure is the same.